it, check it out, y'all. Say check it out, y'all. Doing it down at King's Pizza, y'all. Welcome, welcome, welcome once again to King's Pizza, home of the happy hour that actually lasts 3 hours. That means we got live stand-up comedy from now to 10 p.m. And we also gonna do it tomorrow from 6 to 9. Get that 6 to 9. Get it going. Get it going. All right, y'all. My name is Papa Loco. I'm gonna be the producer for today. And just a quick reminder, I think it's still illegal for us to gather, so keep your masks close in case the popo wanna come. Just keep, you don't gotta wear it if you're eating stuff. So just have a glass of food in front of you, you're good. But if the police start beating me, please protest for me, please. Oh, I hate to be in jail. Nobody know I'm in jail. That'd be fucked up. Like, I want y'all protesting, please. Oh, that'd be fucked up. I'd be in jail just trying to call somebody. Nobody answered it. I can't even call nobody. I don't know nobody's phone number. They got, it's all on my phone. I don't know shit. I'm fucked. Please, go get me. Go get me. We here at King's Pizza. This is the ultimate celebration of free speech going on right here. We're going to put some stand-up comedy. Some of it's going to be good. Some of it might be offensive, so you might hear some shit. But whatever we say here, please react to it. Please make some noise. Make some noise. Make some noise. We're here. The freedom of speech is free. But the pizza costs money, though. That's the thing. The pizza costs money. Please help support King's Pizza and buy yourself some food. And they got sandwiches. They got all kind of... They got the... They got it all. I think it's the side, yeah, something. It's delicious. Okay, so check out the menu. Also, if you're not hungry right now, please buy food for the homeless person and please support our homeless program where we actually, you can buy a pizza. She puts a gift certificate out there, and anybody that's hungry could just go ahead and grab a free pizza that you bought for them. So just help support that going on. So with that being said, we got a homeless dude that's gonna host tonight. No, I'm fucking with you, Eddie. Eddie's the shit, y'all. Like, Eddie's one of my favorite comedians. He makes me laugh all the time because he remind me of me like 20 years ago and shit. Like, you know what I mean? So I was just like, I remember when I was that young. I remember when I had hope in my eyes and I had ambition and shit. Like, that's how I look at Eddie as a younger version of me. But get, please, everybody in the house, make some noise for my favorite comedian, Eddie!
Fuck yeah, Paco. Thank you. I guess that means I'm gonna turn Puerto Rican in 20 years. That's cool. Looking forward to that. Welcome everybody to the Friday night open mic at King's. Hell yeah, thanks for coming out. Yeah, my name's Kenny Kusaka. I'll be the host tonight. It's going to be a good time. Quick round of applause, man, for everybody who makes this possible. Give it up for my man Paco Loco again one time. Paco does this every week. This is all his equipment that he has to bring in here, so it's a lot of heavy lifting. We appreciate you, Paco. Check out Paco's podcast, 808 Hot Takes, with Johnny Sparkles and Pepper Lamb, three of the funniest motherfuckers in Hawaii. What day does that come out? Mondays?
Mondays and Fridays.
Mondays and Fridays. Hell yeah.
95.3.
Yeah. The clit. Yeah, all right. Shit. And round of applause one time for Mushroom, too, and the King's Pizza crew. Every week they give us a place to do this, so it's awesome. Get some pizza tonight from here, all right? Fuck Pizza Hut. Fuck Papa John's, all right? They can all eat dicks, okay? King's Pizza is the place. All right. Tonight's show is sponsored by Drugs. Okay, everybody make sure you buy some drugs and do them accordingly. We're gonna have a good night tonight. All right, if you've never been here before, what we're gonna do is if you wanna perform, just put your name on this paper here. I'm gonna call up each comic one by one. Okay, you're gonna get about 10 minutes to do your shit. And as the night goes on, we're gonna bump it down to 7 minutes, 5 minutes and shit. So if you get here early, you get more time. You don't have to do the whole 10 minutes. Okay, if you don't want to, all right? If you don't, it just means you're a pussy. So, no pressure. Okay, and no pressure. If you bomb tonight up here, also, you're banned for life. You can't come back. All right, so if you don't do well, don't come back tomorrow or next week. Don't bother, all right? Give up on comedy, become a motivational speaker or something. Okay? And that's pretty much it, you guys. You guys ready to start this shit? I don't want to take up too much time here, okay? So I'm going to bring up the first comic. This is the guy that put it all together. Give it up again for Paco Loco.
Yeah, y'all. Eddie, what M stand for, dog?
Mysterio.
Oh, shit. My name is Paco Loco. It was great to be here once again. Felt like a long time since I've been on the mic. Must have been like at least 2-3 minutes. Yeah, so, what are we talking about? Just for people that don't know me, there's Inner Road Money. I'm from Philadelphia. I'm born and raised in Philadelphia. That's why I sound like this. When people first see me, they be swear to God I'm Hawaiian. They be like, oh, boy, how's your boy? I learned pitching the wrong way from this, it was this Instagram channel called Hungry Hungry Hawaiian. And I thought how you say hi was like, soft fuck off. That's not how it worked. Soft fucker. Oh man, it's crazy. I live a crazy life. One of the things I do is real crazy. I MC a lot of games and MC a lot of events all around the island. And I was really famous for this shit until this damn corona hit. I mean, now I'm famous for being an Uber driver. This is, everybody knows me from being an Uber driver. Like, I'll be walking in my block. People are like, hey, yo, you're my Uber driver. Like, yeah, I was. I hate being an essential worker, yo. I hate it. Like, I so wish I was unessential at this point. It's crazy. You know why? Because you know how much stimuluses and rebates and unemployment essential workers get? Shit, we don't get nothing. We out there just dodging it. Like, no, fuck that. Ain't gonna get me. Nope. And then I hear all my friends are unemployed getting banked. Oh, they getting banked. They just money. They just living a life. And I'm sitting there like, fuck. Then I'm trying to figure out how can I sign up. They gotta be something for me. Let me look it up. You know how I can get the stimulus? If I get the corona. Ain't this fucked up? Damn, like I gotta get it to get money, like shit. Then I'm like, fuck it, I did worse for less and shit. So now I'm licking shit. I don't care. Like I just be touching stuff. Just trying to get it. Let's see. One of the things I want to talk about. Just started my Tinder account. I would start my back on Tinder. Yeah. I'm starting my Tinder. I got it back on, and I'm seeing a lot of people in this room that I done swipe right to. Like, how y'all? Like, it's awesome. It's awesome. Until like you keep, like you ain't pay attention, you just look it real quick, like okay. Until I swipe right on the transvestite, like that everybody know and is famous, Brandy Morgan and shit. So Brandy Morgan here, let me know she's here, talk about, she's looking for me. Oh man, what else is crazy? Since we go, let's talk about the news. The news is crazy. I'll do a lot of, this news topic is so much crazy shit going on. Trump might make a comeback. Y'all hear about this? Yeah, they never fixed. It's crazy because of Joe Biden. Like, he's not really there too much. Like, you hear him talk, like, and it's, I'm getting nervous. I'm watching this, like, oh my God. Like, and then we come to a president that talks too much to somebody that don't talk at all. Like, and when he does talk, he's like, shut up, man. Like, come on, man. You running a president. You running the whole country. You making this look bad, dog. Like, oh, fuck. We bombing Syria and shit. You know why we bombed Syria? We finally got them back. Yeah, we finally got Syria back. We bombed the shit out of Syria. Y'all remember what they did to us? Yeah, me either. I don't remember. I don't remember we had beef with Syria and shit. I didn't even know Syria was a country and shit until we bombed it. I mean, that's how it is in this nation. We don't know places until we dare shooting at them and shit. Like, if my brother's in, he's an Iraq veteran. Y'all give it up for the veterans, yo. Oh, giving up. They just doing what they believe is for their country. But we just be sending them on some shit. Like, oh, my brother did 2 wars and we still in Iraq. It's still in Iraq. I thought Hussein was been dead. I mean, why we still in Iraq? Like, oh, they just now talking about we gonna get rid of Afghanistan. We gonna pull our troops in Afghanistan. Like, we still in Afghanistan? Like, for real? Why we in Afghanistan for? What they do to us? Like, they was like, well, 20 years ago, for real? Oh, shit. I remember it because I'm old. I'm old. And then I smoke a lot of weed too. That's another thing. Like, I smoking weed and watching YouTube is a bad combination, dog. It depends what kind of weed you're smoking. Cause they got two kinds of weed that you smoke. They got the sativa and they got the indica. For the new people in the room that don't know how to smoke. And the indica is the blue pill. That's the one that puts you to sleep. And so you just smoke it and you be like, you know what? You see shit going on, like, damn, my country fucked up. But you high, fuck it. You just sit down and start eating chips and shit, like, fuck it, I don't care. Nope. You have a seat,
Thank you. Thank you for coming in.
Liz, Billy.
Hello.
Love me some white women, yo. I love, you know why I love white women? I'm gonna tell y'all why I love white women. White women, they see a brother and they don't see him as an unemployed guy with identity issues and bad credit. No, they see a fixer-upper and shit. Like, they be having hearts and shit. They see you and they be like, hold on, let me take a look at this. They start Googling shit and then all of a sudden they fix my credit because I got some bad shit on my credit. They got it expunged and shit. Yeah, they got it all. I got good credit now. Like, it's crazy. White women hook you up. Your credit rating goes up 25% just by getting with a white woman. I'm telling you. That's the answer to everything. It's interracial sex, y'all. We got all this interracial tensions. There's a lot of racial tensions. Like, it's now the new, I can say this because they're not here, except for Clarice. But the new thing is the Asians. We can't talk bad about Asians no more. Yo, fuck Asians. I don't give a fuck. It's comedy. Yo, coming over here with their delicious food at reasonable prices, 24 hours in dangerous neighborhood. Coming over here, cleaning up the block and shit. Like, come on, who they think they is? Help letting me cheat off them and test us and shit. You know what I mean? Who they think they is? They beautiful ass women. They got these little ass petite women that just humble as hell. Who the fuck they think they is, these damn Asians, though? Shit. Can't stand them. You know what's funny about Asians? Like, yo, everybody, we all pretend like we know the difference between them. Like, I know the difference between the Japanese. I know the difference between the Korean. And I thought I was ignorant and racist because I didn't. You know what I mean? I thought I was like, oh, fuck, I don't know the difference between them. Until I was at a grocery store that's run by Koreans, right? So they in there, they speaking, annyeonghaseyo, they know the Korean. And then these Japanese tourists come in. They was like, konnichiwa, konnichiwa. And then the Koreans and the Japanese looking at each other like, no, no, I'm not Japanese. I was like, oh shit. They don't know the difference either, yo. They don't know. I understand because I'm Puerto Rican. I don't know Mexican until they start talking and shit. You know what I mean? I be thinking I thought Filipinos were Mexicans and shit when I first came here. There's no Filipinos in the East Coast. You know what I mean? If they is, they blended as Dominicans and shit. But on the East Coast, I don't know. It's either you Chinese or you Puerto Rican or you black. That's it. Everybody here breaking it up into different categories. I don't got time for all that. Oh, shit. I'm talking to be a racist. Call me racist, bigoted, homophobe because I believe in God now. Like, that's fucked up. Like, damn, for real, I believe in God. Yo, you know why I believe in God? Because I believe in the ultimate savior. I'm about to preach. Can I preach? I believe in the ultimate savior that did the ultimate miracle of all miracles. My savior turned a hoe into a housewife. Yes, he did. Praise. Yes, he did. Y'all saw the Da Vinci Code. Thank you. Y'all can put some money in the pot later on. That's the only thing I got wrong with religion. They always asking for money. Like, now why are you always asking for money? Like, for real? Like, don't y'all get tax breaks? Why y'all spending it someone like? Oh, I'm going to hell. You know, I believe in spirituality is because I grew up in a haunted house. I grew up in a haunted house where it is born. It's so scary growing up in a haunted house because things just be happening that you just take it as like, fuck it, it's the devil. I mean, so you sitting there like, I be at home and we be as a child with all my brothers and we all of a sudden it gets really cold in the room. I'm like, whoa. You can see your breath. And then all of a sudden you hear like moans from nowhere. Nobody's in the room. You hear, oh, oh. And then like a couple minutes later, my dad walks in, possessed by the devil, just, like, oh, it's the devil. Oh shit, until later on you grow up and then you smoke the indica and you learn the truth. You learn the truth and it's like, yo, it wasn't, my house wasn't even haunted. We just was born and raised in poverty in the ghetto, like, and when the heat turned off, it just ain't no warning. Just doof, doof. And then the moaning, we figured out what that was, because later on in life, I heard the moaning again. But it was different. It was like, turns out my neighbors were just fucking. That's what happens. When you live in a ghetto, the walls are thin. And then it turned out my dad wasn't even possessed by the devil. He's just an alcoholic. Yeah, it happens. He just drank too much, comes in fucked up. My name is Paco Loco. You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, and Pornhub. Don't forget to look there. Thanks a lot. Eddie Mysterio.
Paco Loco, everybody. Keep it going. Hell yeah. Oh, we got a mic stand up here now. Cool. Paco, that's me in 20 years, everybody. All right, I forgot to mention before the show, there's going to be a guy named Rohan that'll be outside probably later tonight. Watch out for him, okay? He's dangerous. You might have seen him on TV. He's been on shows such as Unsolved Mysteries and To Catch a Predator. So, stay alert. Like Paco was saying, a lot of Asian shit going on right now. I don't like the hashtag Stop Asian Hate. I think it's too negative. You know what I mean? I like the. I want to start a hashtag that says Start Asian Love. You know what I mean? I feel that's more positive. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna start the Asian love tonight with the lovely Asian. She's one of the best comics in Hawaii. She's hilarious. You know what I'm saying? If you're a big fan of Silence of the Lambs, you're gonna love her. Everybody, give it up for Clarice Lee.
I think Eddie Murphy is just a disguise. My name is Clarice Lee. Some people also call me Jasmine Bautista. I'm an accountant, so I stay indoors all the time, which is why I'm very light skinned for a Filipino today. I want to give a round of applause to all the comics who came out tonight. You know, they just take time out of their busy schedule to make it here, and I know there's nothing harder for comics to do than to watch other comics. So I just want to give them a big kudos for that. Something happened to me really recently, and it was beautiful. My parents saw me do comedy for the very first time. It was beautiful. I was honestly just so happy that they didn't understand what I was saying. It was really great. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna pull out my material because I don't remember it. I wish you didn't hype me up that well. Thank you, oh my god. I feel bad because I have a joke making fun of white women. And then here, you guys are my biggest fans in the room! Oh my god. Thank you so much. So like, just like these two wonderful ladies here, I too love to go online shopping. I'm a huge fan, and I see all these beautiful models, right? And they're all like tall and thin with long limbs, and they're wearing these tight outfits that are so well cut, and I'm just like, you know what? I think it's about time for me to be a hoe. I think, you know, less sweatpants, more no pants. Right? I see a lot of your sisters in Waikiki Beach. I think showing skin is like the new white privilege. I think that's what it is. Otherwise, how would people still be wearing clothing from free people? And anthropology. How is that? It's just walking around in bras. Not like I have a problem with that, but I'm not wearing one, clearly. So, I'm so happy you guys laughed at that. Thank you so much. So a lot of people shit on America, and I totally get it. It's such a thing. My parents are immigrants. But I don't think people acknowledge America's strengths. If you think about it, we're the only country that made body positivity a thing. Right. Like, that's crazy. And I don't know, I think it's just kind of cool to make being nice popular, right? Like, in America, if you call somebody fat, that's called body shaming. It's very rude. But in any other country, if you call somebody fat, that's just called having an opinion that everybody else also has. It's crazy, and as a result, I love America. My parents are not from America. They're from China, so they are exactly like that. And as a result, I grew up with really crazy body image, right? And I do everything to protect myself from feeling bad about myself. So when I'm on social media, every time I see somebody skinnier than me post a picture, I'm like, mute. I don't need that type of negativity in my life. I can't. Oh my god. Okay, so I'm glad like 5 other people do it too. So I'm not the only one, guys. Oh my god. But to feel better about myself, I'm sure some of you guys do this too, I take some deep breaths. I try to be present of where I am, right? Like be in my body and be connected to myself. And then I just slowly reach over to grab my phone and then I look at what my improv friends are doing. That's what I do to feel better. So some of you guys also do improv, that's cool. Paco was talking about horror movies or living in a haunted house. I don't know why people watch horror movies. I don't. That's a lot of ugly people on screen. And it's so low vibration, right? It doesn't make you feel good. Like, you know what's the opposite of a horror movie? Being happy. Like, I don't need that for entertainment. There's a sunsets and trees and flowers, and I live 10 minutes from a Nordstrom. It's fucking... I don't think anybody who experiences joy on a daily basis is like, you know what I feel like doing? I feel like shitting myself. That sounds like fun.
Or pissing yourself.
Or that. He made me piss myself. Not sexually. It was because of his jokes, actually, which is like the biggest compliment for another comedian. So to go back to my parents, my family grew up in communist China, and a lot of people don't know this, but it's actually Hitler and Stalin didn't kill the most people in modern history. It was actually Mao Zedong. He killed about 45 million people with his regime. Thank you, Paco. It's okay. You can laugh. You laughed at his previous jokes. I already know you're racist. No, it's good. It's good, guys. It's all good. Like, what am I gonna do? Like, tell you that you can't do Chinese takeout anymore? No. I have to support my other Chinese people, so please continue to order at the restaurant. But it's crazy how, you know, like, no one ever talks about the Chinese Communist Revolution, but everyone knows about the Holocaust, right? And as a result of my family, only one generation ago having experienced this, I can't help but be very spiritual and, you know, think about where people come from, really what is humanity, right? And I think we all come from the same place. Like, don't we all just come from and return to the same one divinity, right? Both source, right? Because, like, where do people come from? Where do they return to? It has to be just some immaterial place, right? And that's actually the reason why I'm a huge fan of abortions. Because if you think about it, it's just like a great option for babies that are just here for vacation.
Oh my god. Right?
Like, they come here, they live in Hawaii for 2 weeks without paying rent, and they hop on board their return flight. Yeah, it's like Disney Almani for immaterial beings.
Oh my god.
You think about it. You guys have been amazing. Give it up for your awesome host, Eddie, everybody.
Therese Lee, everybody. Give it up. Hell yeah. Hashtag start Asian love. That's what I'm talking about. Shit. Hold on now. Does this thing tighten or just spins around like this? Okay. You have the right to. Sure, alright. Maybe I'll do it with my penis. Maybe that'll hold him. Alright. Hey, guys. How we doing so far, everybody? Yeah? Good? Alright. Thanks, brother. Appreciate it. Appreciate the man bun. Love it. Alright, man. Hey. We got another comic coming up to the stage. Who's next here? Oh, shit. Here we go. Here we go. If you guys want to know who framed Roger Rabbit, it's this motherfucker right here. Everybody, give it up for Jessica Rabbit, everybody. Hell yeah.
Give it up for your host who puts that shit so high I can't reach it. Ever King's Pizza, of course, because they are gracious enough to have us all the time. But most of all, for the people here who are supporting local comedy, we need to laugh. We're obviously not doing it for the money. You know, the laughs, they get us really happy, and whatever you give us afterwards, it works too. That's okay. You may not know me. My name's Jessica Bullock. But you may have seen me on things like Naked in a Frame and Pranked. And probably my very favorite, Sex Sent Me to the ER. I'll explain that later, I know. Yeah, most people won't admit that shit. I will. But you know, that's how I got really interesting nicknames. Like, Queen of Accidental Happenings. It's You Again. And Boner Killer, which I completely disagree with. I don't think I've ever killed one of those. But you know, whatever. But I do more than just comedy. I work in healthcare, and I have done some extensive research lately. I've been trying to find a cure for depression, and there's a side effect. It left me with some carpal tunnel, yeah, which now has led me thinking a whole lot of other things. But I'm not depressed, and I was awfully happy for those extensive research hours. Yeah, I can't tell you what it is yet, but we'll release that eventually. It led me thinking a lot, and my thinking went to, you know, I probably have had way too many naked and afraid moments, and they're not even my fault. Most things are not my fault. Okay, so maybe that's a small kind lie. Yeah, the naked and afraid I'm going to jail moments, those are only partially my fault. How was I supposed to know the person I was going to flash was a cop? It was dark. Until the blue lights came on. You know, just saying, he should have had those lights on the whole time like they do, maybe not here so much, but Maui, they ride around with the blue lights lit up all the time. I'm like, yes, I am never gonna flash a cop there. Tested it out and I still haven't flashed one yet. That worked out beautifully. But you know, those might be slightly my fault. They are still partially somebody else's fault. It's the little fucker that dared me to do it, and I say little fucker because he's about this tall. I'm not joking, like, dude, he's that tall. How could you say no to that? Like, he says, go do it. And I'm like, no. He's like, yeah, go do it. I'm like, do it first. And he did. He flashed everybody. So I had to do it. Maybe I make some bad choices, but you know, we all do. You know, I just gotta say that it's still not my fault. He shouldn't have said do it, because he knew I would. Yeah, but you know, the other things that are not my fault, like, my ex going to the ER was totally not my fault. How was I supposed to know that swinging testicles would look like a cat to me? I'm serious, I don't have testicles. How do I know how that shit works? I don't know. He was very unhappy about it. And he was a little bit more unhappy when the nurse walked up and said, it's you again. I was like, in my defense, the other times were not my fault either. Just saying. That was the end of the relationship. But you know, he couldn't take it. He couldn't be okay with that because I did warn him ahead of time. Queen of accidental happenings. Keyword, accidents. Shit's not my fault. I should not get blamed for that. But you know, some accidents are good. I accidentally busted a sex/drug ring one time. Yeah, that's how I got the name Boner Killer, and I just don't understand it. Those old fuckers at the nursing home, I saved their lives. Dude, really? And the only explanation I could give was like, Grandpa, I'm sorry. and the sex we're gonna make you back. This is how you know it's my grandpa. His reply is, I know it would have been a happy ending. Like, no, that's all I can think about. It's his happy ending that I messed up. Now I feel bad. I almost want to sneak him a blue pill just because. Can't do it. Can't be the one that makes him die. But, you know, maybe. Who knows? It's one of those, what else can I do wrong? We don't want to know. Every one of you here, you're close enough to find out. Just saying. You're in close enough vicinity that I will drag you in with me. I have these things happen that I don't understand. Taco brings it up. He talks about Tinder. I nearly died because of Tinder. I'm not joking. Serious shit. But this is my fault. This is me. Don't do what I call a Tinder mint. Tinder experiment. Take off all your limits and it's either left or right. Left or right. Until you get one and you decide you have to click. And you have a mint in your mouth. Take your mint out first. Just don't do it. Because I bit down so hard that mint, it went down. And I was choking in the back. And I'm like, oh, swipe right. It's okay, die. Just swipe right, left first. Don't do it, man. Tinder can kill you. Dating can kill you. But you know what's worse? You guys have it way worse. I swear, I think men have it worse than women. Just saying. You know, because I see the shit that women do. Like, they wear padded bras, they wear Spanx, they wear lots of makeup, extensions. You know, I haven't seen too many men that are coming after women that are doing that. So, of course, this is when I had my carpal tunnel syndrome thing going on, so I'm thinking about that. And like, we need to improve those commercials. Cover girl. Cover your shit up, girl. You'll never know until it's too late. Yeah, I've seen some of those. They wake up the next day and the guy's like, what the hell? Favorite time, I have my friend in the mainland call me and he says, look at the picture. And I look at him like, oh, no. You did not go out with her. She is too hot for you. And he goes, no, look at the next picture. Oh, my God. She was probably wearing baby nails. Maybe it's a girl. Maybe it's not. I don't think it was. He swears it was. I think he's lying. That's why he didn't tell the boys, and he only told me. Because he was lying. That wasn't a girl. But, you know, y'all have it worse in most ways. But men, y'all gotta work on your pickup lines. Just saying. I had one guy decide to bump the back of my car, and I was like, what the hell was he thinking? I know what he was thinking. One bang would lead to another. It did not. I got smart. There was cops close. It was just a motor vehicle accident. Can't do anything where I could get arrested and be naked again. But, you know, maybe here, since they're not ever around when you need them. But that's my time, guys. And I will call up Eddie, who is somewhere out there doing his thing, like chilling, walking around out there. He's just like, keep talking, Jessica. You can keep talking. Come on, Eddie.
Jessica, everybody. Sorry, I missed that whole last part. Fucking mopeds and shit. Okay. Oh, man. Good shit. Boner Killer?
I know.
What was that? Your nickname?
Yes, that was from the people at the old folks' home. They were mad because I took their blue pills.
Oh, that's
after.
Oh shit.
Yes,
that's
kids.
Crazy. That's why I hate old people, man.
I know. Like, I saved their lives.
Yeah, exactly. Like, fuck you. I used to work
no,
in a,
exactly. They couldn't fuck anymore.
Yeah, I used to work in a retirement home.
I used to.
And I used to give all the diabetics, they used to ask for sugar-free ice cream and I give them regular.
Yeah.
It was cool. Anyway, good shit. Where are you from again, Jessica?
South Carolina,
hell yeah. I love that accent, man. Makes me want to storm the Capitol building. All right, guys. We'll keep it moving with your next comment. If you guys are fans of the band Capenna, get ready, because that's this guy's name. Everybody, give it up for Capenna, everybody. Is he out here? Oh, there he is. Hell yeah.
Yeah, the man, not the band. The man, not the band. So I just realized that this is like a community. It's only like the fourth comedy event I've been to. So I'm now realizing it's a community. And I decided that the best way to get you guys to know who I am is tell you how I lost my virginity. So I was 19 years old. I didn't live in a castle with you guys. I felt like I was a princess. I went to school with all these really rich kids at Buna Ho, and I thought I was Cinderella, and I had the evil stepmother. And so I was kept in the home all the time, very strict home. And then at 19 years old, I was working at the airport, and that was way back in the 80s, I'll just say the 80s. And I don't know if you guys know anything about the airport in the 80s here in Hawaii, but a lot of beautiful people from Hawaii used to work in the airport. All the tourists would come in and see the most beautiful people in Hawaii. They had late readers, they had models, they had all these beautiful people in the airport. And I got to be a male model for this photo place. And one of the girls invites me to a party. So I'm like this nerd virgin dude, you know, that now I gotta stand in the airport and meet people from all over the world and give them a fake kiss on the cheek, you know, with a little song. And there's this super gorgeous Chinese Filipino girl asking me out on a date. I'm like, yeah, definitely. So it was actually a party for all the airport workers. And the word had got around that the guy that just started working for Kahala Kai Photos is a virgin. And I didn't know that that meant the women were going to come after me. So I'm at this party, and I'm sitting next to the woman who invited me there. But the other really sexy, gorgeous girl that worked at the airport slides in and sits on this side. So now I'm thinking I'm living in heaven. And all of a sudden, these two older women, they're like 6 years old, and they're like rubbing my legs. And I'm thinking their hands are going to meet pretty soon. And they're having a competition. And I ended up going to take my date home. Because I was a nerd, I was a gentleman, I opened the door, I took it to the front door. And she's like, no. You have to give me something. And I was like, huh? And she just grabbed me by the back of my hand and she started kissing me, just kissed. Like, it just made me melt. And it made me rock hard at the same time. And she pushed me back into my car and she said, take me down the street. So I take her down the street and she's like, turn left, turn right, turn left, turn right. And we end up in this dead end. She's like, park right there. So I pull the car around and I park right there. And then she climbs in the back seat. And she's like, come here. And I climb in the back seat. And we're kissing and making up. And she pops one out and puts it in my mouth. And I'm like, wow, my first real poopy. I couldn't believe it. I was like, what am I supposed to do with it? I don't know. I was supposed to, like, I think there's a little bite it, nibble, I don't know. What do they like? I'm not sure. And she popped the other one out. And then she reached down. Next thing I know, we're naked. And then I'm trying to figure out what I'm supposed to do. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. And I'm right there. And I'm trying to find it. I don't know. Can I look down? I'm not sure I'm supposed to look down. Can I just feel my way? I'm not really sure. And then, all of a sudden, she pushes me off of her and she says, are you a virgin? I was like, yeah. And she reaches down and grabs it. Puts it right on that spot. And I feel all this heat. And then I'm thinking, oh, it's finally gonna happen. And then all of a sudden, I hear this, pew, pew. And there's a flashlight shining on my jaw. There's a police officer standing outside the car. And he's like, everyone needs to put their clothes back on and get out here and mind their own. And you guys still don't know how you lost my virginity. That shit happened. Okay, so anyway, I moved to New York because I was trying to be a famous actor. And I ended up living on the Lower East Side, 6th Street, Manhattan, between B and C. And I brought my dog from Hawaii with me. His name is E-E-Pa. E-E-Pa. E-E-Pa is like the demigods of the Hawaiian people. Like they're demigods. You know, women slept with the gods and they had these E-E-Pa. And the E-E-Pa, their home was on the valley where the Oahu Country Club is today. That was their home. That was a very sacred place. So anyway, E-E-Pa. I didn't know, like, I was in a Puerto Rican, Dominican neighborhood, and they had this thing that they would do. They'd go, "Wepa!" So when I would introduce my people would say, "What's your dog's name?" I'd say, "He's E-E-Pa." To them, it was "Wepa!" And because of the way I spelled my name wasn't Capena, it was Capena. So I became Capena for 5.5 years while I lived in New York. And I ended up taking my wife to her favorite restaurant in New York for her birthday. So I had to get this Monty in advance, Robert De Niro's sushi restaurant. And when we get there, we're taken to our table. And you know you're in a really fancy place where they take you to your table and they never come back. Because they knew we were nobodies. So we're sitting at this table and my wife is all buried in the menu and she's all happy because she's at a restaurant. She's looking at this menu. I'm sitting there trying to get the waiter's attention. And every time he looks at me, he like gives me this look like, "You're beneath me." So I'm trying not to be mad because it's my wife's birthday. And then this guy walks in the front door. Warning. I was like, "Man,
warning.
I've seen this guy. Seen this guy before, but I don't know who he is. So could you, And my wife turns and looks and she goes, "Oh my God, it's Tom Selleck." And I didn't recognize him because he didn't have his mustache. So they take him over to his table, which is across the restaurant. And I tell her, "I'm going to go say hi." So I stand up and I run across the restaurant and go say hi to Tom Selleck and tell him, "It's funny, all the years you're in Hawaii, I never met you, and now I'm meeting here in New York." I said, "You see that beautiful woman over there? That's my wife. And she just told me, even though I'm an actor, that you're her favorite actor." And he laughed and she says, "He's beautiful. Would you like me to say hello?" So he comes over to our table and he says, "Happy birthday to my wife," gives her a hug and a kiss. And then we're gonna go sit back at our table and he goes back to his table and now everybody in the restaurant thinks we're somebody because Tom Selleck came to our table and said, "Hi to my wife." Alright? So when now there's a waiter camped out right at the edge of our table for the rest of the evening. And then my wife's like, switch seats. I'm like, "Why?" So I wanna look at Tom Selleck for the rest of the evening. And I was like, "All right, whatever, it's your birthday." So we switch seats. And then right after we switch seats, Tom Selleck's date arrived. And my wife starts like, no, not Tom. I was like, "What?" She goes, "Look." And I turned and look. And Tom said it was totally different out with this tiny little petite Asian. But my wife's problem was, she was a guy.
Oh.
And she's like, "Okay, that's it. Tom said it's not my favorite anymore. Now I only like Joe Montana." So that's how I met Tom Selleck in New York.
The pen, everybody. Keep it going for him. Hell yeah. Fuck yeah, dude. Did you say, "Hey, Capena"? Where'd he go? Did you say you saw Tom Selleck without a mustache?
Yes, he did!
Holy, that must have been terrifying, dude. Holy crap. It's like seeing Anthony Negroni with a beard. I was like, who the fuck is that guy? Holy shit. Good God. I hate waiters too, man. He's talking about how waiters are assholes. I hate them too, man. Straight up. There's a guy named Trey out there he used to be a waiter. He's a fucking dick. I told him to buy me good beer and he brought PBR, you fucking asshole. Anyway, we're gonna keep this shit rolling. This next guy, one of my favorites, one of the best comics in Hawaii, one of the best writers I've ever seen. He's got a huge cock. Everybody give it up for Ian Shippen, everybody.
I am really hinting right now, Eddie. I can't even work this microphone stand. You want me to do fucking comedy? You want me to do? I asked the crowd for like three topics earlier, like three random people for some topics, and they gave me education, sports, and midgets. And instead of writing, I got really high with Trey outside.
Yes.
So that's not happening. So what's new with me, guys? I've been pigging out a lot. And I thought that I had gained 1,000,000 pounds, but it turns out that I only gained 3, so in my mind, I've already lost 999,997 pounds. Hey, it's time for cheat day, guys. Some pizza and shit. I don't know. I've been working out, though, guys. I've been working out. No, nothing? Nobody gives a shit? Thank you. That's right. Fuck me now, ladies. Fuck me now. My self-esteem is still super low. Fuck me now. Because in 4 months, I'm going to be ripped. And you can't have this, Chanel. Yeah. I'm going to be like a unicorn. Yeah, that way 4 months from now, you can brag to all your friends, like, I fuck Ian. And they'll be like, oh, damn, girl, he fine as hell. Fuck Ian. Fuck me now, ladies. That's terrible. What else do I want to say? My boss was telling me congratulations on your weight loss journey. Wow. Journey. The Polynesians crossed the Pacific Ocean using the night sky for navigation. Neil Armstrong traveled 240,000 miles in space to get to the moon. I told Sheila at Subway to hold the mayonnaise on my turkey sandwich. That's my weight loss journey, guys. Thank you. What else is new, guys? My dad doesn't like to give money to homeless people because he's afraid that they're going to spend it on drugs and alcohol, but he paid for my education. Education. Where all I did was drugs and alcohol. Like, I remember this one time, like, I was, like, with a group of friends, and we snuck into school, right? For some reason, we would sneak into school at midnight, and then we would do, like, cocaine and drink and shit. And I remember this one time, we actually got caught. This is a true story. And the security guard caught us, and all my friends ran away. And you know that saying, like, you don't have to be the fastest person, you just have to be faster than the slowest person? Yeah, slowest person, guys. Slowest person. And it didn't help that they were all on cocaine, you know? So, yeah, I got caught, good stuff. That was my education. Who said that? Paco said that one. What did you do? You did sports? We'll see. What else? Sorry, guys. I'm cheating today. I'm high as fuck. Let's do this. Let's see. I'm single. Where are my single people at? Yeah. My best friend is also single, right? We like to go out of the town to try to pick up women. We make it a game of sorts as to who can get more numbers, and after night of fierce competition, we're tied. 0-0. It's a bad game of soccer. No one's scoring at all. Yeah.
It's a really
bad
game.
Huh?
That's a good game of soccer.
That's a good game of soccer? No scoring? Oh my gosh. Like, what did I say? Did we talk about cooking? I did. What else did I need to talk about? Midgets? Midgets was the third subject. Why don't we talk more about cocaine? Yeah, me and Trey, we like to go and hang out, and all the girls love Trey, because Trey has cocaine, Chanel. Apparently that's what all the girls like, is cocaine. Like, I remember he had cocaine at O'Toole's once when we were over there, and he came back from like the bathroom, and he's like, Ian, I fucked a 6.5 in the bathroom. It's like, 6.5? Like, first of all, why are you bringing decimals into this? 6.5. I think that the scale should be 1 to 3, believe. 1 to 3. No, maybe if I was drunken. Hell yeah. Like, maybe 1 to 4 if she had cocaine. Right. Working it out. Working it out. Anybody ever do friends with benefits? You have a friends with benefits, Paco?
That's my shit.
That's your shit? That's all you do? Yeah.
That's all I'm available for.
Remember I was at this party, and this one girl had made Jello shots, right? And she comes up to me and is like, I made Jello shots, Ian, but I know you don't drink anymore, so I made you this special one with no alcohol in it. So I was like, oh, wow, you made me Jello? Thank you for the Jello. But anyway, I had her Jello, and we were talking and stuff, and one thing led to another. And, you know, things were getting heated up. And it was like, whoa, 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 are we actually doing this? Are we doing this? And she's like, yeah, but we need to create some rules. So we did this Friends with Benefits thing, and we created rules. The first rule was don't tell anybody, right? Don't tell anybody because, you know, we had mutual friends. We don't want anybody to know, right? Second rule was no feelings. If any of us felt feelings, we would put a stop to it right there, and it would be over. And then third one was no spending the night and no cuddling. And I was like, whoa, 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 wait a second. Look at me. Chanel, I am the epitome of a cuddler. Right? Cuddling needs to be part of my Friends with Benefits package. So she's like, okay, you can cuddle with me, but for only the amount of time that the sex lasts. So I had my work cut out for me. It just became a series of us breaking the rules, right? Like, rule number one, don't tell anybody. What am I doing right now, guys? Telling the world about this. Rule number two, I remember this, like, it was our first time, and, you know, it was kind of tense, because we'd been friends for a while, and so I put on Netflix to kind of kill the tension, right, because you gotta Netflix before you can chill, right? So I put on Netflix, trying to ease it up, and she did this cute thing, right? She did this cute thing where she took her pinky, and she grabbed my pinky with her pinky, and our two pinkies were, like, holding each other. That was the cutest thing that I had ever seen. Thus breaking rule number two of catching no feelings. Oh, man. But then we did it, guys. We did it. We had sex. And it was hot. And it was passionate. And it was everything that I needed it to be. And then I held her in my arms for 42 seconds. 42 seconds. And then she left. Yeah. And she was a midget. That's all I got. Let's bring our host back up here, fucking Eddie M. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, all right. Eddie M. Let's bring our host back up here, Eddie M. Let's bring our host back up here, Eddie M.
All right.
Sorry, what
are you
doing, like, 3 minutes?
Are you good? Yeah, you good. Ian Shippen, everybody. Biggest dick in the comedy scene. Literally and figuratively. Nah, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. He is the nicest fucking guy in the world, bro. Biggest dick, but nicest guy. Okay. Keep it rolling here, you guys. Yeah, everybody doing good still? Everybody doing good? Good? Okay. Doesn't sound like it, but that's fine. We trot along anyway. All right. Letting you know again, if you bomb up here, you're banned for life. So no pressure. But I'm gonna bring the next comic up. Everybody do what this guy says, because give it up for Simon. Yeah. Get it?
Yeah, we get it.
Hey, everyone, how are you guys doing? Okay. Well, as the MC said, this is probably my last time up here by bomb, so. But anyway, I moved to Hawaii about 6 years ago, and when I moved here, I bought a sailboat. I've been living on a sailboat since I came. And that sounds really exotic, but as I explained to my friends at home, the reality is I'm more like the aquatic version of trailer trash. That's the way to put it. I rented a car recently, and I like nice cars, so normally I rent really nice cars. And in this case, they didn't have any nice cars, and they were out, and they're like, we're sorry, but the only thing we have is a Ford Fiesta. And I'm like, what's a Ford Fiesta? But, you know, I'm thinking, wow, with a name like Fiesta, it must be like a really fun car, right? And then it turns out that it really isn't a fun car at all. So, but I mean, I'm driving around in this Fiesta and I'm thinking this should be called like I don't want to be seen in public with you or something like that. But then I thought, you know, what if this car, stupid Fiesta, really lived up to its name? What if it was so fun that the Fiesta was actually powered by fun? So imagine the more fun you're having, the faster the car goes and the longer it drives. You know, so you just turn on some music and you're like, woo, you know, I don't actually know how to have fun, but you know, you get the idea. But say you want to go on a long trip. So I got to drive for 3 hours and I have to have fun for 3 hours. So I pull into like a strip club and I hire some strippers. And the strippers come in, they're having fun, they're partying, and the girls in the back are dancing and doing lines of coke, and then the other one's up front, and she's, you know, trying to figure out how to work my stick shift, and then we're all having a grand time, and, you know, and the car's moving fast. But after a while, you know, everybody gets sick of it. You know, after an hour, the girl's in the back, they're like sick of twerking, the girl up front, and she's getting a lockjaw, and I'm just getting tired, so he's pulled, and I let the girls out, and then I have to continue on by myself, trying to have fun, but, I took the all I got for tonight. Say again? Yeah, it's tiny. So the strippers were pretty small, so yeah. Where's IMC? Eddie? Ian, get Eddie.
Give it up for Simon, everybody. All right, he's banned for life. oh, shit. Where'd everybody go? What the fuck?
They're all outside.
Jesus, what? You guys are the crowd. What the fuck? Gosh. Everybody, give it up for Simon one more time. Okay, we got another Regal name coming up next. Is there a